Hello everybody, welcome to a new Legacy video. Today, in honor of the memory of Andreas Ganz, a Swiss player who passed away last week, I decided to play his deck, Dredge, his deck that he played in GP Bologna, a GP that I have a good memory with him since I intentionally drew with him in round 16, so we both made top 8 of that GP, which is also happened to be my last GP, so I'm now happy to, playing the deck that he played up there in that tournament. I made only one change, which is to add an Ox of Agonis, who's a Theros card, so came out after GP Bologna, pretty strong in Dredge. But yeah, his deck was basically a blue-red version of a Dredge with Fairy Islet as not only, of course, a blue-red spell, a blue-red land, but also an enabler for the late game to make so that you don't break off, and that's pretty sweet. Dredge is a deck that uses Careful Study, Faithless Looting, Breakthrough, Insolent Neonate to, like, and of course Lands of Diamond to, you know, draw and discard. In Legacy, you also have access to Cephalid Coliseum, which with Threshold draws 3 cards and discards 3 cards. So you ideally, you just want to get the Stinkweed Imp, the Golgari Thug, and the Golgari Grove Troll in the graveyard. And then you have creatures that come into play from the graveyard, like Ikorid, like Bridge from Below. And finally, the newly, kind of newly, you know, legacy cards, Ox of Agonis and Ogak, Arisen Necropolis. You, the sideboard is an interesting one. There's the Dread Return, Flamekin Zeloth, Iona package. And this happens to come in against faster deck like Sneaking Show and Ad Nauseam Tendrils. And then you have Leyline against other graveyard decks, and finally you have Shenanigans and Chain of Vapors and Lotus Petal in the matchups where you want to fight the hate pieces, something like Mono Red Moon, or whereas against various decks it would just only bring in Lotus Petals. Basically not sideboarding zero against Delver. That's what I'm expecting to do today, and let's head into a Legacy League. This video is sponsored by ChinaFireball.com and Ultimate Guard, and they are the best place to go if you want to know more about top Magic content and your card accessories. Alright, we got game number one, round number one underway. We're on the play with what looks like a pretty good end here. Thanks to Straight Raid, we can go off as early as turn one here. So removing a mind counter is casting Faithless Looting. Hopefully it's not Force of Negation. Force of Will would still be pretty good. Yeah, it is Force of Will. Pitching Ice Fang Quaddle. Okay. Ooh, Wasteland. Alright. Not exactly sure what my opponent's playing. Ooh, Careful Study, that's a good draw. Let's go again. Discarding Golgari Thug and Ikorid. Yeah, and then I'll cycle Straight Rate. And instead of drawing, I'll replace it with the Dredge of Golgari Thug. Anarchamoeba comes into play. That's it. I have no other Dredger, unfortunately, and not even a Cabal Therapy. So there's nothing I can do here except passing the turn. Ikorid can come into play next turn, so I can technically cast Ogak next turn. That's funny, because I can go Ikorid, Exiling Straight Rate, and then I can cast Golgari Thug to flashback the Ogak, which of course can get plowed, but you know, that's a threat I can put into play. I don't want to cycle Straight Rate to draw a card. I think that's just wrong. The opponent is playing Ice Fang Quaddle, so I'm assuming they play a control deck, so there isn't that much rush. With this Wood of Wooties, I'm expecting them to play some sort of Temur deck. Temur control without Delver. Wow, yeah, Birds of Paradise. Okay. Every time there's some ban list, you know, Death Rush Shaman or Astrolabe, people just play Birds of Paradise. It's just kind of like... Okay, anyway, let's put into play Ikorid, Exiling Straight Rate. Then I draw a card. Golgari Rift Troll. Yeah, as I said, I want to play Golgari Thug here. This resolves, and now I can cast Diogak. Pink for black, black, colorless, and four. Leaving the Faithless Looting in the graveyard and exiling the irrelevant stuff. The strip rate was exiled before. So yeah, now the Ikori dies. And if my opponent plays Timur, they don't have Oko to turn Ogaki into an elk. And if they don't have Plow, it's going to be pretty tough. They could have Jace Bounce, I guess. Tarmogoyf. Sure, that's a 4-5. Remember that when the Golgari Thug dies, you put target creature from the top, from graveyard to your top. So it could be nice with Stray Rate. Upkeep, I can cycle the Stray Rate to put into play Quarried. I just don't want to do that though. I'm just untapping here. I was hoping to draw land to flashback Faithless Looting, but that didn't happen. I think now it's fine to cycle. I really want to hit a land. Instead, I hit a Bridge from Below, which is below the acceptable targets, I guess. What do I want to do? So if I attack with the Ogak here, they take 8 and then they attack me back. I guess I can't win this race. I'm on 13 with two CD, with all my lands being CD of Brasses. The thing is that if this game goes long, do I win or do I lose? I think I win if, like, eventually I'll just either, I can even, like, go Discord phase. The problem is that if I chump block with the Thug, I guess I can chump block with Narcomoeba, but no one gets hurt. All right, I think I'm attacking. Honestly, I can go as far as attacking with Amoeba. They bolt my Thug, it's a bad deal if they bolt my Thug, though. I guess I can win this race. All right, you know what? I'm attacking with both. I changed my mind about this race. And I'm passing. I have the Ikori coming in next turn. Opponent will definitely have to like chump block the Ikori. Then next turn I can decide to maybe not flashback the Amoeba. Sorry, to maybe not attack with Amoeba. The Ikori that doesn't have a trample, but the Hogak does. The Hogak, last sentence of Hogak is trample. Uro. Okay, sweet. Uro. I guess Uro can raise Hogak. The three cards in hand, Prismatic Vista. Yeah, so the external opponent will be able to. I guess the mountain is kind of bad with Yogak. All right, no Stifle. I was afraid of Stifle for a second. The Suspend Ancestral Vision. Okay, that's the last card of my opponent in hand, was a Birds of Paradise. And I'm taking 4 damage if they attack me. I'm sure they attack. No, they don't attack me. Wow. I guess they stopped the Ikorid that way. All right, then I don't want to get back the Ikorid. If the opponent gets back that, because this is the last Stray Rate. Yeah, I'm attacking with the Ogak. Opponent, I guess, doesn't want to block, because if they attack, I can't just dredge the Golgari Thug and bring it back. I would have definitely done that. Alright, we'll keep on attacking with both here. My opponent will not be able to bring in. I guess they will be able to bring back the Uro here by chump blocking. Although it's just pretty tough life to chump block. Yeah, I keep on attacking like this. Golgari Thug makes like for a pretty good blocker since my opponent, since if they block with it, since they attack, I block and then I can just dredge it back and recast it. Even if I, you know, don't dredge anything good. Opponent draws for a turn and they can flash back Uro. Let's see if that's what they're doing, or if they've drawn something different. For sideboard, they have. I don't think my opponent will bring in Cage since they play with Uro in their deck. So I'm not bringing in anything. The only card that you can bring in this matchup is really just the Shenanigans, but I don't think I'm going to sideboard any card here. Yeah, so they got their Uro, no graveyard. Thermograph is smaller now, funny. There's only creatures and sorceries. And if I get back Ikorid now, oh, what did I draw? Red and green. They draw Tarmogoyf. Okay. And if I bring back the Ikorid, exiling the Stray Raid, Tarmogoyf becomes a 1/2. Huh. Does that mean that I have lethal if I bring back the Ikorid? Because the Tarmogoyf being a 1/2, yeah, they can block the Hogak pretty badly. I think they might just need to chum block the Hogak in that way. Yeah, I'm gonna bring back the Ikorid now. So now the Tarmogoyf are so small. It's funny how I just basically never casted a spell after that Hogak. So if I attack just like this, what can they do about it? Maybe I'm attacking with everybody. If I attack with everybody here, they like triple block the Hogak and they take 5 down to 1. Yeah, they can't really do this. I think this is a good attack. Really, really cool. Really, just really fun game, honestly. Just, this is just good magic. You know, I'm just grinding turn 6 attacking against Hogak versus Uro. I've barely cast 2 spells this game. Mm-hmm. Okay. Interesting blocks, I guess. And by interesting, I mean not very good. I don't even know what is a good block, honestly. I mean, that block wasn't the worst. Like, they take... Oh no, they die. That block was bad. I just realized that was lethal. Alright, so they do this block. So we'll be killing Uro and the Bad Art of Tarmogoyf. So they take 5 damage down to 1. Their Tarmogoyf is slightly bigger now. Yeah, can cast a spell, so I'll pass the turn. They're on 1. Tarmogoyf dies. Sorry, Ikorid dies. And they're surviving here. If they don't draw anything, they have to double chum block with the birds. such a crazy game. I don't think I'm winning, honestly. I'm just waiting to draw either a card, draw this card, or a land for Faithless Looting. But I'm not drawing anything, so I just can't do anything. I will exile the Hogak here, I think. Yeah, I think I will. Oh no, okay, I guess. Attack it with everybody. They have to double chump with their birds, because they're on 1. This way, by double chumping, they can't even bring back Uro. Because they have that mountain. Even if they get enough cards, they can't fetch because they're on 1. Even if they find a bolt here, it's still like, I mean, the Narcomoeba's flying. This is a really fun game. Okay. Yeah. Now it's awkward because, all right. Yeah, so what happens here is that, so damage happens, Golgaritha goes on the graveyard, and its ability goes on the stack, and it should put itself on top of the deck. I think this is the time to just draw a card with Fairy Islet and dredge it instead. That way I'm also going to discard. So, I go to 12. And instead of drawing, I dredge the Thug. Okay, its ability happen, and nothing happens because there's no creatures in the graveyard. Alright, second main phase. I have 1 Cabal Therapy in the graveyard, which I can now use to put maybe 2 Ikorids in the graveyard. What can I put in the graveyard? Because if I put 2 Ikorids in the graveyard... I think I'm just putting 2 Golgari Grave Trolls in the graveyard, honestly. So I Cabal Therapy myself with the Thug, with the Ikorid that's dying regardless. Maybe I wasn't supposed to do this because I go to discard phase anyway. Nah, I think it's fine. I'll just get the Golgari Grave Troll out. Right? If I discard... Yeah, but discovering this Golgari Grave Troll, the Ikaray isn't coming down, but they have a Tarmogoyf anyway, so I think just discarding Golgari Grave Troll makes the most sense. The two Golgari Grave Trolls. Yeah, I passed the turn. Now I'm on 12, their Tarmogoyf is a lot bigger, it's a 3-4. My opponent vision isn't up yet, and they're on 1 against my Narcomoeba. They can't bring back Uro. So I think this is a pretty long, grindy game one, but I think we got it. Alright. Nice game. Thank you, Algak. You did a very good job. So yeah, not sideboarding anything in this matchup, as I've explained in the deck tech. You don't sideboard much against the fair decks, and I've explained how and when you sideboard each of these cards. Yeah, let's get into the game two. Sideboard games. I have one enabler. Might not be enough, but it can also go in the discard phase if needed. But we'll see how this game evolves here. I'm not Mulligan, I have Sapphire Cloud Zeal, that's also another enabler. And not Fairy Islet. What? Yet again, another enabler. Alright, so they go Ancestral Vision on turn 1. Another particularly scary draw. Yeah, drawing Golgari Grave Troll just what makes me want to move to discard phase. And again, if they have a Cabal Therapy, sorry, a Surgical Extraction, that's fine, I'll live with that. Okay, looks like we are untapping and dredging. What's left in the graveyard? There's two Ikaris, wow. Cabal Therapy, sorry, not Cabal Therapy, Fiddler's Looting. Okay, so there's two Ikaris in the graveyard. Yeah, I think I'll, I think I'm gonna go discard phase again. Yeah, that looks the most solid of the options. I'm not drawing Lion's Eye Diamond, now that I think about it. I should really be drawing that card. Alright, let's see what they do. Ice Fanko Auto, maybe. Okay. Ancestral Vision, slowly ticking down. Let's see, they could play Oko. No, they can't play Oko. They can play Clothis. They can play Wallbreacher. Clothis, God of Destiny. Interesting. So this one will make so that every turn they have this like pingy of one. Alright, I think I will bring in an Ikaray here. Yeah. I will exile another Ikaray, which isn't amazing, but I do like to have a creature here. Whom I can flashback a Cabal Therapy with. Alright, I got a Narcomoeba. Not much else. Yeah. I think I'll attempt to cast a Faithless Looting and let's see how they react to it. I can then go Cephalid Coliseum. I have built a good amount of graveyard to turn on the Cephalid Coliseum by itself. Oftentimes, if you don't go to discard phase, you just can't do that. I'm very happy I decided to take that line of, as I said, just move to discard naturally. I'm attacking with the Ikaray. If they block, sure, they can then exile my Clothis, the Ikaray with a Clothis, I'm okay with that. They will be able to exile the only creature that I have, which is that Stinkweed Imp. Okay, they took the damage. Yep, that's good. So now Clothis will be able to exile the Stinkweed Imp if they want. Unfortunately, they're going to have a straight rate to punish them for that play. Although I would have probably cycled in my turn to find for a Cabal Therapy for the Ikaray. Again, going to discard, I just want to repeat that for the new players. Going to discard naturally is a good play to play around force decks. And that one turns on the Cephalid Coliseum. So my opponent wisely exiled the Stinkweed Imp. And we move to my turn where I'm drawing a Golgari Thug. Yeah, it's just not great because I just don't have black mana to cast Cabal Therapy. That would be nice. I mean, I could go Cephalid Coliseum, draw this card, and just put 3 dredgers in the graveyard. That way I can start some chain. They have that clothes though that makes it hard. Makes me very hard to go to the Discord phase. Yeah, I think the best I have as an option is to just Cassified Colosseum in my opponent's turn. Sacrifice, target player draws three cards and discard three cards. Yeah, because I have nine cards in the grave. Yeah, I think what I'm doing here is attacking with Amoeba. Remember that every time you have a bridge in your grave, you don't want your opponents to lose creatures. So if I can get in some damage with my Narc Amoeba, I like it. They also have an Ancestral Vision popping off. I don't expect to win this game. Maybe the plan of going to Discord wasn't as solid. I was supposed to mulligan for a better hand. I don't know. Anyway, I cast this and pass the turn since I have no treasures in my graveyard. I'd rather just set up something next turn. Yep, so they draw five new cards this game between the Quaddle, sorry, this turn. The Quaddle, the Vision, and the draw step. Wondering if they play Shardless Agent or just, play Ancestral Visions for value. It's a pretty slow value. I mean, it did get there, but that's maybe because I'm not, mulliganing that aggressively. But I do think that against Force of Will and Force of Negation's deck, mulliganing aggressively isn't really get rewarded, isn't really rewarded. Oh wow, they exiled Faithless Looting instead of Ikarid. I guess I'm in Flashback territory, but I'm gonna Stone Rain end of turn with the Sapphire Coliseum, drawing three, discarding. I mean, depends what I draw, but for sure to go Garagrave Troll and something else. If they find like a Surgical or stuff like that, it'll be very hard for me to win this game. Oh yeah, they do a Shardless Agent. Interesting. What do they cascade to? A Birds of Paradise. That's not very impressive. What did they reveal? Blackbird Elf, Dead Gone, or Rough Tumble? Okay, sweet. Okay. Wasteland, huh? End of turn, I'll target myself. Go to 13. Ooh, Land's Eye Diamond, that's sweet. So I'm discarding the troll. I am discarding maybe just Troll, because I want to put into play an Ikorid. So maybe Troll. What else can I do? Cabal Therapy Thug, so that I can go Ikorid, exile the Troll, and then I can Cabal Therapy. Maybe like some Bridge from Below. If I could discard more, I guess I have Land's Eye Diamond to discard cards. Yeah, I'm sort of discarding a Thug. Yeah, I may just keep the Cabal Therapy. If I draw a black source, I can cast it. Yeah, I'm just discarding like this. All right, let's go. Hopefully, done out of a Surgical. Wasteland, sure. Since I, have Land's Eye Diamond, Faithless Looting, I just want to put all the treasures in the graveyard. Okay, so I am exiling a Thug, and now draw step. I will dredge six. Oh, sorry, I don't know why I thought about drawing card. I can't, of course, I can't draw any black mana. I'm all right. Anyway, I found a Cabal Therapy, which isn't bad. So I can Cabal Therapy my opponent, but then I have no bridge, so I will have no creatures into play. So it's weird because if I cast Land's Eye Diamond, actually, maybe what I was supposed to do was discarding a bridge and just get lucky with a Cabal Therapy. It was the same though. If I just, mill one bridge and no Cabal Therapy, then I would have wanted to do that, to do the opposite. All right, I think I just have to do this. I just have to get like Narc Amoebas and so on in my graveyard. So I just Cabal Therapy my opponent, naming Force of Will, and then I'll hope that this they don't have a Force of Negation. And I'll resolve my Land's Eye Diamond Faithless Looting thing. Oh yeah, Force of Negation. Yeah, that's bad. It's very bad. Let's see if this resolves. I mean, even if it resolves, I mean, it's weird because they have like, you know, for sure four force of wills and maybe two or three force of negation. Yeah, I have no more outs. All right, good game. You know, had they drawn a force of negation, a force of will instead of a force of negation, I would have gone Lion's Eye Diamond, discard my hand, get three red, Faithless Looting, and then if I would have milled at least 10 cards, or at least 11 cards, and then if there was an Archimede, I could have just, you know, floated the board with zombies, discarding my opponent 10, and so on and so forth. All right, we go to game number 3, where hopefully I have a more explosive hand. I'm still not changing a card, and yeah, let's go to game number 3. Game 3, again, this very sweet match so far. Yeah, let's go. I guess this is a sweet hand. I'm going to sequence it in this way. Cast Lion's Eye Diamond, see if it resolves. Then Gemstone Mine, Careful Study. In response, cycle 3 rate, discard my hand. So that I will have these three cards in the graveyard as I resolve this first and this second. Of course, it will be, we will see what they counter or what they don't counter. But that's the idea. Like, the ideal sequencing of this hand is the following. All right, I'm putting Mulligan to 5. Let's go. Kick things off with a Lion's Eye Diamond. Lend. You have to hold full control. Careful Study first, because it's a sorcery. Then you cycle, still hold your priority. And then finally, you discard your hand for 3 red. All right, this is a sweet screenshot to take. I think I will take this sweet screenshot. Yeah, this is some sweet. All right. Yeah, let's click OK. Well, I'll put it now as priority. So I'm dredging 6 first, then I attempt to resolve this Careful Study. Dredging 5 and dredging 6. Discarding a 6 for sure. Guess it doesn't really matter. Alright, yeah, I passed the turn. I was hoping to find a Faithless Looting to flashback with Lion's Eye Diamond mana. Or, you know, an Archimede or something. I didn't find anything. But, you know, as long as my opponent doesn't go land the heal spell bomb, we're okay. The Mulligan to 5, so hopefully they don't have that. Just suspend an Ancestral Vision opponent. Pump land the heal spell bomb. If I get a turn here, I'm sure I'll, you know, get good. But Birds of Paradise, oof, okay. So, yeah. Ikorid comes into play, I'll discard a 3 rate, and then I'll dredge for 6. Nice. Four Cabal Therapy in my graveyard. Attack first. That's 3 damage. Oh, I forgot about that. That was a mistake. Oh, that was a huge mistake. That was a punt. All right. Now my Bridge from Below will be exiled, and I don't get any zombie for sacrificing this Ikorid. Oy, oy, oy. Hopefully I can recover that. Just too busy thinking about screenshots and game over, blah, blah, blah. I punted. All right. Let's name Tarmogoyf first. They do have it. Yeah, pass the turn. So they have a Wasteland, a Brazen Borrower, and Ancestral Vision, which I'm sure they'll be suspending. And they'll be Wastelanding me? I don't know. I don't think... I mean, I'd love, actually, if they Wasteland me, because I'm not really planning on casting any other card or drawing any other spell for what it's worth. Yeah, in fact, they don't discard my hand. My card, sorry. All right, anyway, Ikorid here. Exiling the Golgari Thug. And that's it. I can't discard anything else. I'll dredge 6. There's an oxomagonus, a second bridge, that's lucky. Sorry, a last bridge, because that's the fourth one. It's very lucky. Now, do I want to discard a Brazen Borrower? I guess. Do I have any dredgers in my graveyard? There's a one Golgari Thug. I can also just target myself with the Cabal Therapy and just leave them with a Brazen Borrower. And just they'll bounce a token, don't really care. Yeah, I think that's what I'll be doing. So I'll target myself and name Golgari Grave Troll. I also haven't found a single Narcomoeba so far. So there's four Narcomoeba in the 24 cards over there. Yeah, as I said, I don't care about that petty theft bouncing my zombie, so I'm okay with it. So this one is a three. So yeah, we made a huge pawn that maybe cost us the game, so let's just try to keep on playing well. Tarmogoyf withdrawn is a tough one. Let's see how this continues. Ikarid finds itself a thug. That's okay. A other Ikarid doesn't come into play. And then we cycle six. We dredge six, sorry. There's two Narcomoebas. There's a straight rate. I am attacking with... am I attacking with Ikarid? I can't Cabal Therapy them now. Yep, naming Brazen Borrower. The Blob Red Elf in end. Okay. Yeah, I can't Cabal Therapy again, but I don't want to sacrifice an Narcomoeba because that one attacks. Whereas the Ikorids cannot attack into that Tarmogoyf. Where's the Hogak? Well, yeah, Hogak is the card I'm looking for right now. Okay, so there's for sure a Sri Rate. And that's it. Nothing else. So let's dredge six. We go to 12 cards in our deck, and that's the Hogak. There it is, the Hogak. What do I want to do here? Certainly. So, I think I want to keep the last Cabal Therapy for my opponent's Blob Red Elf, maybe in the future. So here I'm just casting the Gak here. Tapping black, black, black. And then attack for two. Ikor dies and I get a 2-2 zombie. I don't want to discard any of my card. I have 12 cards left in my deck. There's two Narcomoebas, as far as I know, and that's it. I don't think I have any other relevant card. Might not even cycle here. Sorry, might not even dredge here. Yep. So that's good. I'm exiling a thug and an imp. Do I want to dredge six? Yeah, I think so. I still have six cards in the deck. It's plenty not to deck myself. Yeah, now I'm attacking with everybody. I don't care if the Tarmogoyf kills my last bridge at this point. They might actually be dead on board here. Probably they are, in fact. All right, this is game showed you what not to do with that bridge. But other than like that mistake, which of course was very costly, I think this was a very good game, which, you know, kind of taught you maybe how to just, how to show you how the dredge is a slow and steady deck. Like, it gets there. It might get there slowly, especially like you saw in game one, but with the newly added Hogak Necropolis Reason, it gets there in this grand matchup. Yeah, again, I've reached from below as a second text with it, and I hope you guys enjoyed this first match. I'll be back for round number two. Round number two with a very good hand. This hand is very explosive. I play against Achilles 27, who's famous for being a Maverick player. So I am expecting them to go Landbirds again, maybe. We're gonna get double opponents that leads in Landbirds. Yeah, I go Fairy Islet, Breakthrough, and responses Karma Hand here. Oh wow, it's actually happening. Instead of birds, it's just the Zenith for Dryad Arbor. Yeah, so I'm going Fiery Islet, Lion's Eye Diamond, Hold Priority, Breakthrough, and discard my hand floating. Do I want to float red? Yeah, definitely. Okay, let's go. Dredge 6, Dredge 5, Dredge 6. Dredge 5. Discard 4 cards. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. Alright. Dark Amoeba, you can come into play. Yes, thanks. And then I'll go Fateless Looting. Dredge 6. Dredge 6. Discard 2 cards. Alright, it's just turn one and I have 18 cards in my deck. It's like, feels like I casted like one of those, discard your hand card, you know? Okay, now I'll, Cabal Therapy my opponent. Put into play the Bridge from Below. Four of them. So I'm not attacking first. I'll name, Source Supply Shares. And this is why you don't need a Dread Return, combo game one. Because game one, you just do this. And then this is probably a better screenshot in the last one. And then you do this, and then you just discard their end. Plus sideboard in the matchup where, I mean, how can this not be enough though? Like, I don't understand why you have the Dread Return plan, really. Anyway, playing against, Rest in Peace, probably. Pretty sure I can go on, Achilles' Twitter and see his latest list, because yeah, he's really like a maverick aficionado. He plays every challenge. He has done also very many good results. I follow him on Twitter. So yeah, I think it's just going to be the pedals. This was his sideboard. This is Dresgan sideboarding in the against the you know, Rest in Peace decks. And yeah, you don't want the Chain of Vapors shenanigans. Yeah, let's just go with this for now. We'll see after game two. All right, we are in game number two. Yeah, I'm mulliganing this end. All right, I'll keep this one. Let's see if I guess Chain of Vapor is good against Leyline. And I guess my opponent is the kind of deck that would play Leyline. Let's hope we move to... So opponent is doing all the mulligans. I guess let's follow them. I just realized that maybe we should be mulliganing. Alright, my opponent has kept only 6. And I also keep... I forgot I have to bottom a card. I guess is this, but I mean, again, if my hands work, I just win, right? All right, please don't have a ley line. No, this is a ley line. And I can't beat it. Oh yeah, I should definitely have the cage. I should definitely have the Chain of Vapors. All right. I should have definitely had the Chain of Vapor, right? I think I'm just scooping it up. Yeah, I scoop it up. Yeah, this is not a proper sideboarding, but that's okay, there's always game three, right? But also now we'll have the idea that they just need to do that, and they win. I think I'm just boarding out the Cabal Therapies for the chains. Maybe I don't need the pedals. Yeah, one petal to erase the number of blue. Yeah, this seems better. Yeah, let's go with this. Game number three on the play. All right. There it is. That's the ley line. Okay. I'll pass the turn. Once upon a time. We have the breakthrough next turn where we can pay. We'll see, maybe I just cycle next turn at this rate. This hand would have been so good if they didn't have the ley line. Imagine if they have if they had like cage. Yeah, maybe they couldn't have stopped it. Anyway, they got Noble Hierarch. They found a good card with the Once Upon a Time. They found a Stoneforge Mystic. Let's go cycle. Careful study. What am I doing now? Discarding like this. Playland pass. Yeah. Stoneforge. Go get the jet. I'll break through. X equal 2 here. So I'll draw 4 and keep 2 cards. Discard 4 cards. So 4 cards from this will be going to the exile. What's the 4th card I want to discard? Is it the looting or is it the chain? Think it's the looting that I want to discard. Unfortunately, though, I mean, they can't cast the ley line technically. They're just green white mana right now. The problem is that they have a jit. Oh, they don't? Weird. They didn't give. Wonder what they plan on doing. Okay. 12. Maybe they go Zenith for. Okay. Let's begin with Chain of Vapor here. Bouncing the ley line. Now, I'll float blue, because I need blue mana for the Colosseum here. So I'll float blue, and I'll draw a card with a Fairy Islet. I'll dredge, and then I'll have enough cards to trigger the Colosseum. Oh, wow, that was a pretty bad, that was a pretty terrible dredge. Okay, I can cast another Colosseum and do it again. Hopefully I can find a better dredge this time. Okay, so the Narcomoeba coming to play. I boarded out all my Cabal Therapy, so I don't have a play now, and I just passed the turn. 2 bridge from below. Yeah, maybe not having any Cabal Therapy isn't good. Yeah, I'm just learning here. And yeah, maybe you should always keep like a couple of them. This is just tough anyway, because like, I just discarded so many good cards in the early game that. Evolgak? Do I Evolgak or did I discard it? Do I have it? Okay, I have no Ikarid. That's weird. Sure, I'll dredge six. No play available, unfortunately. Yeah, the Jit will just clean one of these and exile my bridges, and I'll lose. All right, good game. Good match, good match. We've definitely learned that against Maverick, you have to bring in the ley line. Sorry, they're bringing the ley line, so you want the Cabal Therapies, and we've also learned that, sorry, we want the Chain of Vapors, and we also learned that you have to keep a couple of Cup Therapy, maybe. Anyway, this game was already compromised, even if I had a couple of therapy. I just took too long to find the Chain of Vapor. All right, let's be back for round number three with Dredge. Round number three against Jace DMS, who won a challenge with Banned Miracles, or rather, Banned Control. So, yeah, I'm expecting this to be a pretty slow matchup. So this is clearly a keep with a careful study. Where once again, oh wow, it's not. Ha ha. Ha ha. See, had they not played Petal here, I would have gone to discard. Just saying that if you play Sneak and Show, it's sometimes right to just go to discard. Sorry, to not to hold your Petal. Anyway, of course, I can't hold my things anymore and go to discard. I have to act. And yeah, just dig deeper. Dig deeper for the Cabal Therapies and so on and so forth. Force pitch show and tell. Okay, force pitch show and tell. Do they have two show and tells? They do have two show and tells. All right. Yeah, I'll put a Golgari Grave Troll that goes into the graveyard. Can I ever beat a Grizzlebrand in the main deck? No, I can't. All right, let's go do the. Oh, I've been drawn lines a diamond though. That's not bad. No, but I just can't beat a 7/7 lifelink, I think. That also just wins the game the following turn. All right, maybe this is the scenario. I mean, that's what it says. Just bring in this against show and tell and etc. And I will stand by that. So I'll board out these lower and grindy cards like Ogak, Insolent Neonate, and Stray Wraiths. And bring in the Dread Return flanking Xaeloth. Oh, sorry, wrong guard and Iona. Yeah, that's the plan. Stray Wraith, Insolent Neonate, and Ogak out. Yeah, let's go with this. I actually made some changes in the end. I brought in the Lapetal as well, cutting one land, one Ikarid, just because I expect. I need to be fast, and I think that this is exactly when you want to be when you want to bring in the petals. All right, that's a keep. Lots of redundancy with this study and Faithless Looting. I'll begin with probably just a looting here. Could go Cabal Therapy targeting my opponent eventually, but I won't go now. I won't go now. So yeah, I'll go Fiery Islet, Faithless Looting. Discarding City Ikorid and Gemstone Mine. Ooh, Gravedigger's Cage. And that's it. That's it. That's the end. No outs to that card. Yeah, good game. Let's be back for round number four. Games are going fast. Let's join the match for the final, sorry, the fourth round. We are on the play. However, my opponent was playing some Yorion Pile Avenge one time. So, not that it really matters. Just saying, you know, just talking, just doing some talk. Legacy players love to, you know, calling each other master of certain decks. So, yeah, I kind of like to do that on my little platform here. Yeah, there's very little I can do about this. There is a little combo with Insolent Neonate and a bridge where you just make a 2/2 for one mana. And if the with a Faithless Looting I find a Dredger, I can just play that, play Neonate instead of Breakthrough. This is Veteran Explorer. You see, I knew they were playing some sort of 80 cards. Lion's Eye Diamond. Alright, what's the sequencing here? Because I have to discard a card, I have two sorceries. So I think what I'll be doing here is just cast a Neonate first. Cast a Neonate first, then Lion's Eye Diamond, then Breakthrough X equals 0. This card, my end. Was this a good play? I'm not sure this was the best play. I'm not sure this was the best play. Anyway, I go Faithless Looting. Discard two cards. Yes. I'll go Cabal Therapy. Naming. Huh. Who do I want to name here? I mean, Cabal Therapy doesn't make much sense. I guess I'm naming Grayson Zenith. Titania, push, Baleful Strix. Okay. That's it. I've made my turn. Could have been better. We could have sequenced better, maybe. Maybe I was supposed to start with looting. Maybe I was supposed to just play careful Breakthrough X equal 2 instead of casting that Neonate. X equal 1. Maybe. Alright, my opponent just plays Savannah. I remember they can kill their Veteran Explorer to this card. To clean up my bridges from below. Here's a couple of that. Dirge 6. Ooh, there's another Cabal Therapy. Ox of a Goddess. That seems sweet. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that, shall we? Problem of Ox of a Goddess is that if I mill too many bridges. Let me think 1 second. Because they can't just push this, huh? And exile my bridge. I guess whatever if they do that. Just game one. Nothing really can go badly in game one. Escape mechanic. To not confuse with delve mechanic. Alright, so Ox of Agonas. Discarding my hand. Dredging. Six. Okay. Now you can get rid of your Veteran Explorer and all my bridges, but I'll be flashing back the Ogak, of course, as well as having lots of other things into play. So yeah, I'll put into play the... Do I want to Cabal Therapy my opponent? Yeah, I guess. Alright, well, I got something but I'll push at this point. Ooh, Arena Rector. Yeah, what else do we want to do? I'm casting the Gak. And then I'm attacking. Maybe not. Maybe stacking with a Menace. I don't want to give them lands, probably. They can go like Arena Rector, top deck. They can go like Arena Rector, top deck something, and I just, I don't know, lose. So I just stack with a Menace one and pass, making some Zombos. Next turn, I should be lethal. Or maybe not. Well, we'll see. I mean, I don't think there's any way they can get over this board state. So as long as I don't die to like Arena Rector into, I don't know, a planeswalker that doesn't like Ugin, I guess. Yeah, they can get Ugin. And next turn, if they block the 5/3, they take definitely more than an 18 damage. So yeah, I think it was right to do what I did. Not that it was very hard, you know. It's not very hard to win game ones with this deck, unless your opponent puts Grisselbrand into play and Force of Will on turn one. Okay. Now I am aware of the testing of previous matchup. So I'm bringing the Chain of Vapor. Cutting a Tuchel Therapy, and maybe like one Neonate, one Sriret, one Neonate, one Sriret. These are like kind of the worst cards. I guess they do dig for a chain. They don't really dig though. Yeah, this is okay to me. It's game two. Did my opponent just kept seven? They kept seven, and you know what? I also keep seven. And if you have ley line, yeah, I mean that's the life of the dredge player. You can put ley line into play, opponent. I'm waiting for you. Even the client says waiting on Rikimaru 6 to put into play ley line. What do I do if they do that? I'll just cry probably. That's what I have to do here. There's nothing much else to do, I guess. Just. I don't really want to mulligan to find chain. Like, you have to find chain and the functional hand. This deck doesn't have that many hands that are both, you know? Sure. If they didn't have the chain, the ley line, I could have gone like Fiery Islet, Land's Eye Diamond. Straight raid this card my hand. As it is, I am doing nothing. I mean, I guess I am cycling this. Nice. I can go. No, I can go Black Lotus Bridge. All right, just play a land and pass. I mean, I'm just Arcasting Thugs and Imps and Bridges. No, you don't want to Arcast the Bridge. It does literally nothing. It's one of the most awkward card. I mean, in future sight, I need a lot of awkward cards. But Bridge from Below, that is crazy. That's pretty crazy. It's pretty crazy. And in the art, there isn't even a bridge. They're just a guy. I'm curious to know if in the newest art they actually have a bridge. All right, let's see if they discard my Land's Eye Diamond. I guess I could have played it. Why didn't I play it? Yeah, let's get two basics. I don't have them. I played this combo in pre-modern. I played this combo in that format. That's pretty sweet. My Alolan deck in pre-modern. I do the Veteran Explorer Cabal Therapy combo. But you have to do it with the newer art. And in paper, of course. Oh wow, that just got a bridge. Oh, that's so funny. Quite speculations, true. To player for up to three cards with flash weapon and graveyard. Cobalt Therapy, Echo of Eons. Okay, opponent. Okay. You're having fun now. You have your ley line, and you can cast all your quiet speculation, echo beings. You can do all your stuff now. You're free. Nobody is stopping you. Except this Golgari thug. This Golgari thug is stopping you. To take you down. You and your Cabal therapies. Quiet speculation. Did you also draw a card with this card? It doesn't draw a card. Oh, wow. It's not like the... That's the one that we're saying food chain. Manipulate fate. That one draws a card. Manipulate fate. Yeah. Quiet speculation. I mean, it's basically no such a recall if you think about it. Put three cards and flash back in the graveyard. Alright, let's see if they have an arena reactor. They haven't made a land drop yet. Because they don't have it. Our opponent, I am beating you down. I am. That is my plan here. I go Golgari Thug, Stinkwadip. Turn one Lanzai Diamond. Turn two Golgari Thug. Turn three Stinkwadip. Turn four Ikarid. Attack with all. No, they have the Arena Reactor. They're gonna sacrifice it with the Cabal Therapy. What do you got? What Planeswalker do you get? I once made a video with my opponent deck. Oogie, there it is! I remember. It was like a blue-white miracle deck with the Arena Reactor. It was just when Battle Bond came out. So when was this? It's not rated. But yeah, it was when Battle Bond came out. I made that video. Wow, I've been making legacy videos for a long time here. Chain of Vapor. Alright. Even if I sacrifice this Fiery Islet now, it's a little bit tough to beat Lo Spirito Dragon. Okay, game number three against Rikimaru. Will we battle against Leyline, Arcage, or not? We'll see. You'll be back for round number three. Sorry, four, game three. Okay, it's our game number three on the play. Boom! I did say boom, and I meant it. That's a keep. This hand is amazing. Then out of Leyline, you're dead, because they go... You know, the thing. Actually, I might not even do the thing. They mulligan to four. Oh, this is what I love to see. Two, three, see, mulligan. Three, four, two. If they mulligan to two, I can't even just win by hard casting, maybe. Nah, probably not. I did have a good curve earlier. Thug into Twimp. Or it looks like they... They're thinking about it. On three cards. If they go ley line, we go boom, bounce, boom, boom. No! No! Oh my god! Oh no. No, Mangu, no. Alright. This is a challenge. This is a challenge, chat. Sorry, not chat. Video. Will we win a game where my opponent basically just started a game with one card? It's probably a Savannah. Do they have a one drop? Oh, they do! Oh my. Okay. Oh. I think I'm going chain here, right? Yeah, I think I have to go chain. Problem going chain is that they just fetch for black. But if I draw another chain, I think I have to go chain. Just have to top deck another chain soon. Oh yeah, I'm losing this. Oh my god. Can't believe it. Yeah, I think I'll go break through and just keep a card in hand. What am I keeping? Yes, I'm keeping the Colosseum. Just digging. Digging to find a chain soon. I mean, I'm assuming my opponent will give me a lot of turns, so not that soon. Okay. I'll go to 15 here. Island, okay, that one doesn't cast ley line at least. Okay, we found it. Although I have to find more dredgers now. I'll wait on it. Right? I think I'll wait on it. Brainstorm? No! No! Okay. It's reinforced. That's one black. Yep. I think I'll take a draw step here. I don't have cards in my graveyard to cast it. To escape it. All right, so they shuffled, meaning that shuffle the way up. All right, so this is a try on black, so we'll be able to outcast the ley line. So I got a 10. I'll go to 10 here. Yeah, I'm not bouncing the ley line. I'll wait. What do you have? Quite speculation. Yeah, I mean, I lose this game. I put a mulligan 2-1. My opponent mulligan actually mulligan to one. Right, they don't flush back the therapy. Ooh, very virtual. I can't do anything, unfortunately, though. Actually, I could have done something. If I just remove a counter from the Gemstone Mine EOT, I could have had a shroud, a threshold. Because I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I could have a threshold. Whereas as it is, I don't think. Actually, I can target my own Lion's Eye Diamond and sacrifice a land. Return target null and permanent to its owners, and then that permanent control must sacrifice a land. If they do or does, you may copy. All right, so we can actually sacrifice the land here. Yeah. So what I'm doing here is, okay, let's try this. I mean, I have nothing to lose. Next turn, my opponent will kill me, so I have to go off now. All right, so I'll go at blue. Chain of Vapor. This Lion's Eye Diamond. Yeah, so I'll click OK. You may sacrifice a land. I will. I'll sacrifice this land here. And I'm bouncing the ley line now. Nice. Okay. Oh, it's in the exile though. Everything is in the exile. Oh, even the chain is in the exile. I didn't know that rule. So even in the chain is in the exile. So I didn't have a way. Even if I don't do that play, I still can't get the seven cards. All right. I guess I lost again. I didn't have a way to get around my opponent. They just recast the ley line, Cabal Therapy me. They can just get black. All right, congratulations, opponent. You have defeated me from this position here that I screenshotted. We have a very good hand. Opponent with one card defeated me. That's impressive. All right, looks like if you play the challenge, everybody packs so many ley lines that you can't really function with these decks. Yeah, that's tough. I think I'm going to drop. I don't want to play anymore. But I hope you guys had fun. The first few games were fun, though. Actually, the first match was fun. All right, I'll be back, guys, for another Legacy video next time. And thank you for watching, and goodbye.